Anyway, from the inside here to the inside there, I've got about 51 inches. If I go up about a third of the way, somewhere in here, I think I measured right there, I got 49 and a half, and that's specs. And then up at the very top, right where the quadrants come together, I measured 49. And the weird thing is, all the way back here at the rear shutter, I measured 50. So I don't know why it's about a half inch over. Between the SCCAs is 49 and a half inches. So when it got to the top there at 49, it was basically, you know, pushing the dome halves apart. So I've got the spreader bar in place. We'll get maybe a better view of it. There, you can probably see it a little bit better going across. That's a 5/8 inch threaded rod. And I've got brackets on both sides. We'll go up and take a look. I've tensioned it, and we've now spread the dome halves to a 50 inch gap, which is, you know, as close to 50, it might be 49 7/8 or something like that, but it's close to what it is on the rear shutter. So I can see on this side, the SCCA is about half, maybe 3/4 of an inch away from the edge. And over here, it's not much. We're not, the top shutter's not centered, but there's maybe an 1/8 of an inch gap. So when we get to the top, we should slide easily through that gap rather than what it was doing before. It was chugging just to push stuff out of the way. Okay, let's see if I can get this. Yeah, a little bit hard to see, but I might take some pictures too. But this is a bracket, just an L bracket. Drilled 2/4 inch holes here, 5/8 of an inch hole here. Got the hole a little bit close to this side, so I had to machine it out a little bit, but works well. Most of the stress right here, or actually all the stress, is right here on the ends of the Grundwich flange. You can see over there, there's no nut or anything on the back. It's just the threaded rod coming through. There's the two carriage bolts. And of course here, I've got my 5/8 inch bolt in the washer. Probably didn't need the washer, but hey, it'll help. I guess it helps for machining. So I put the ends in, and then I spread. That one had a little bit more overhang on the other side, so I spread it from that side. Not that it matters, but this, yeah, it's really, really tough, and it's pushing it apart. Like I said, we're at a 50 inch spread. It seems like it's holding it well. All the stress, again, is right here, right on the end. So we should not have a problem keeping it spread even over time.